So, it's finally time for the age of AI to take over the anime industry, and it is honestly for the better. So, if you want to hear more, hit that like and subscribe, and let's just get into it, shall we? Because this is quite an annoying yet long one. So if you can hear the enthusiasm in my voice, it is because I've had this notion for a very long time in regards to the Western anime community. If you guys don't know, as of recently, a few anime studios or productions are starting to use AI for translations, and this was done around about, you know, a few months ago to maybe a year. My time lapse is a bit dodgy in regards to Shueisha, where they were offering to do AI translations of their, I guess, manga plus or any future releases in the back end. Now, of course, this is a bit cringe and a bit weird because I have constantly complained about Viz Media doing the exact same thing as machine translations, especially for their Bleach light novels, Cannot Fear Your Own World. Now, granted, it is Viz, and their pure job should be translation, like that's what their job is supposed to be. And when you can't even define what Infinite is, and you can't really spell Mugetsu or the Mugen correctly, and just little things like that, I kind of wonder what I'm paying for, because I might as well just read a fan translation online, right? But hey, anything to do to support your own series in your own country, right? Haha. But anyway, I did have this stance against AI translation for quite a while, and then once this news about Shueisha was doing it, I was still on the fence. But after thinking much about it, after this recent controversy, and yes, there is a controversy, and it is so sweet, because the translators or the localizers, especially at Funimation, and even some, I guess, manga translators, I'm not quite sure, they're all crying on Twitter or X because they're about to lose their jobs. And it couldn't be more beautiful, because as I'm learning more about this situation, it just keeps getting worse and worse and worse. And the translators just don't know how to shut up, and they're digging this amazing grave. And I couldn't be happier, because I've been saying for the longest time to stop, and I know it's really hard, but stop wasting your money on poor products. And I understand Crunchyroll and people like Funimation have a monopoly. I get it. Like, it is what it is. But maybe it is time for Scanlations and, you know, piracy to kind of flourish until they learn how to be actual human beings and not NPCs, like, unironically. But anyway, so here's the rundown of the drama, and then I'll give my two cents and then we'll leave, right? A bunch of localizers are complaining because of the whole AI thing of, like, AI's taken over them. Now, when people went back and looked at these individuals and their translations, they're not the best translations, and you want to know why? Because they use Western slang terms such as yeet, or, you know, resting bitch face, and political agendas like the patriarchy, I can't even say the word, such as patriarchy, and then something about mansplaining at one point, and Among Us memes, and I'm just like, your job is not to, you know, fuck up these translations. Your job is to get a piece of anime, take it from Japanese, and turn it into English. It's a very simple concept, I understand. I don't know what the complaint is. So why you justify or glorify yourself on Twitter to be like, I did this, I made it better. Like, shut the fuck up, you pretentious twat. Your job, I don't care what your political view is, your job is to translate what it says in Japanese into English. That is your job. Not to be a dickhead, right? And then, obviously, this picks up some steam, and, you know, some streamers and some YouTubers have talked about it. I learned this through Chibi Reviews, and then I went to Asmongold, and I was learning more and more about this. And then, for some odd reason, Jamie Marchi, the girl that, you know, kind of sued Vic Mignogna, the same woman that went online and started saying, you know, threats about Vic Mignogna, saying that he would chop off his dick and balls, you know, quite a normal thing to say in a professional setting and not have repercussions for your actions by the company that employs you, seems that they advocate for that type of behavior. She's going out online arguing with every single person ever, calling anyone that's a Nazi for disagreeing about her changes within the script work, and then proceeds to say, oh, by the way, nobody at Funimation knows how to speak Japanese, so they just, I mean, I'm paraphrasing, not paraphrasing, but yeah, like, they don't know how to speak Japanese, so they're translating on their own kind of thing. What? Funimation, explain, like, your job is to turn anime and dub it and make it English, and you can't, you have employers that are doing translation jobs that can't speak Japanese or understand what? You know, there's only so much, like, it's not funny. Like, I want to laugh. I'm, like, trying to force myself into this coping situation. But I've been doing this for a long time. You know, especially when, you know, Bleach was coming out, you know, on a weekly basis. Even down to the Hell Arc where they called ghouls beasts. They aren't beasts, because if you have any slight knowledge into Bleach, you would know that the Beast Realm are not the same as the things from the Hell Arc. And there were the literal translation was ghouls. I even said this in my review. I don't know why Viz just failed to do the most simplest of tasks. And then they censor as well, especially from Nini saying, like, fairy tales are bullshit. And then they change it to fairy tales are full of it. Like, why are you so scared to use swear words? Why aren't you doing your job as a translator? Translator with the word, you know, it's a T, translate. You know what the word is? Go Google, search what the meaning of the word is. Your job isn't to change things because you feel like it. That's what your job is. And I can't reiterate enough the concept that these translators are struggling really bad to understand that they're arguing on Twitter about, you know, why they think they're justified, but they're not, and they don't actually get it. That's the weird thing, is that they're actually scratching their heads going, why are we getting this hate? And then the moment that a streamer that's relatively big, which the anime community is bigger than Asmongold, by the way, but the moment that one person, Asmongold, responds to it or kind of reacts to this whole situation, this whole mess, Jamie Marchi goes out on a video and starts not only saying Asmongold is making a problem of this and his fans are attacking me, but also goes on to elaborate how many followers he has, just so she can victim blame herself. Seems very, very familiar to a certain situation. I can't really put my head into it. Point is that this is a bit of a weird situation and a bit of a weird video, but I kind of wanted to talk about it. Am I against AI translations now? Yes, but I think what the thing is here is that I'm actually for this situation. And I think it's all about trust. Do we trust the companies doing the AI translations? And the question is that do people trust the Japanese more than they trust the American companies? And the answer is an undeniably yes, because Japan isn't going to fuck up their own series. I mean, yeah, it's probably going to be like a cost efficient thing, whatever. But they've even said that, like, AI is going to do the translation and then they're going to actually pay someone to actually just fact check it, which saves so much of the legwork of just starting from like 0 to 100. Instead, you're probably doing like 70% to 100% once the AI is done, which is like so much more efficient anyway, and it stops piracy to some certain degree as well. Don't know how it's going to go with magazine scans, but still, it's going to save a lot of money and a lot of time, and it's more efficient. And that's what makes sense about business. Here's the thing, AI can be used in so many beautiful and amazing ways. The unfortunate thing is most people on Twitter or on the internet see AI as like the picture, you know, altering thing that steals from artists, and AI just being the bad part of AI when AI does some amazing legwork, especially when it comes to research development. It's a fantastic tool. But the question is who do you trust? Do you trust Shueisha looking after their own properties, or do you trust people like Funimation and Crunchyroll and translators? No, I wouldn't trust them with AI at all, because they're shit and they don't quality control them. We see that from the Bleach Can't Fear Your Own World light novels. We literally see AI be misused. And it's unfortunate. This isn't political. This isn't, I mean, if I wanted to get political about it, I could, you know, because they all look the same. The people complaining and bitching and moaning either have like bald heads and soy jack faces, or they're females that are relatively overweight and they have a lot of hair color, much like they want to be in the cast of My Little Pony. But that's besides the point. Stereotypes exist for a reason, and in this case it's always the same looking people, and I don't understand why. It's just like, nobody asked, just translate the damn thing. Like, it's quite simple. You learn Japanese, you understand what it says, you write it down on a script, you bing bang bosh, you send it off, and that's your job. Your job isn't to be a pretentious political activist cunt. With that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. And as always, people, peace out.